Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and I can't wait to discuss the muscles that we are going to locate for the anterior neck and thorax session. So let's start with the muscles of the thorax because they're larger and I think they're a little bit easier to identify. And we will start with the pectoralis major. And I'm going to kind of outline this on both sides. You can see a pacemaker that's kind of embedded in this particular region. And the nipple is here in terms of getting an idea of about where that location is, because that's helpful in terms of being able to understand at what region the pectoralis major is, just deep, obviously, to the skin. So the pectoralis major is, as we know, going to have an attachment to the sternocostal region, as well as up here in terms of the clavicle. You can see about a little bit where the clavicle is and kind of following down in that sternocostal region. Now, you don't see where it's extending to the humerus, but recall that it is going to have its distal attachment all the way on that proximal humerus region. And so if you're looking at this view, if you've dissected this particular region and removed the subcutaneous tissue, it's generally one of the first muscles you'll see, and it'll be quite dominant. It'll be near the deltoid. That's going to be more in the shoulder region. And if you extend a little bit into this inferior region, and you can see it a little bit better here, you can see these really nice kind of sawtooth fibers associated with the serratus anterior. So we'll only see a little bit of the serratus anterior in this particular dissection, but it has this very, very dominant, very characteristic sawtooth appearance. And it'll be just inferior to the pectoralis major. I would say inferior and lateral. Now, in order to see the pectoralis minor, you have to reflect the pectoralis major. It will not be visible until that happens. And what that means is you will cut the attachments of the pectoralis major, and in this case we've cut some of those more proximal attachments in order to reflect it up, leaving its attachment on the humerus so you're not completely removing the muscle and still being able to see a good amount of the pectoralis major. And then underneath here you will see the smaller pectoralis minor muscle. And so it's going to have this attachment on the ribs, and then it will extend to the coracoid process of the scapula. So you can see, I cannot see the pectoralis minor on this side. I can only see the major because I have not reflected the pectoralis major. All right, moving to muscles of the neck, and really the first muscle that is, I think, easily identifiable and kind of help you get your bearings for other portions of the neck is the sternocleidomastoid. And I'm going to start with this kind of posterior lateral view. And I'm going to outline the sternocleidomastoid. And it's this very prominent, very rope-like, or kind of large strap-like muscle extending all the way up from the skull. So that mastoid process, and then that region there, down to the clavicle and the sternum. So very dominant in terms of that. You can see the external jugular vein that is going to be traveling obliquely and superficial to the sternocleidomastoid. So a very dominant feature in the anterior neck. Here you can see both sternocleidomastoid muscles on this side. And again, there's that external jugular vein there. All right, the sternocleidomastoid muscles have been reflected in this particular dissection. In order to be able to see some of the deeper structures, and we'll focus now on the strap muscles, or those infrahyoid muscles. So I always like to find the hyoid first, which is right in this region here. And we are looking at a more superficial dissection of the strap muscles, meaning that we are looking at the superficial layer of the straps. You're going to have the large sternohyoid right here. And it is extending from the sternum all the way to the hyoid. You can see that over here as well, with a vein kind of running over the top of it there, which isn't uncommon at all. So this is the sternohyoid, very strap-like in terms of its appearance. The omohyoid, as you recall, is a little unique in the fact that it has two separate bellies. You're going to have a superior belly So from hyoid to this intermediate tendon that will have an attachment to the clavicle. And then the inferior belly is going to be inferior, as its name would suggest, and then you kind of lose it a lot of times in dissection because it's heading towards the scapula. So unless you do a much more destructive dissection in this region, you wouldn't be able to see it quite as well. So there is that superior belly, intermediate tendon, inferior belly. This particular dissection is a deeper dissection of the strap muscles. You can see again the hyoid bone right in this region. This is the thyroid cartilage, which is part of the larynx, and we'll get into that more in our session 3 with the larynx and the pharynx. And so from here, you can kind of get an idea of which one is which based on our understanding of where the hyoid and the thyroid cartilage is located. So you can see the sternothyroid. So here's that sternum. So the sternothyroid is going to extend from the sternal region up to the thyroid cartilage. Not all the way up to the hyoid as the sternohyoid would have. And so really that sternohyoid has had to be removed in order for us to even be able to see these muscles. And then the thyrohyoid will extend from the thyroid cartilage up to the hyoid bone, as you can see here and here. And you can see we're medial to the carotid sheath contents, and it's all about being inferior to that hyoid muscle. And so if you have any of these muscles in this region that are inferior to the hyoid, you need to be thinking strap muscles, and then just really work on understanding the names and kind of being able to break down those attachment points, and that will be helpful in terms of being able to identify these. All right, so those are the muscles we need to be able to identify in this session. Again, in terms of the thorax, those are larger muscles. They'll be a little bit easier to identify. In terms of the muscles of the neck, it's all about those attachment points and really being able to understand where those are located. All right, thank you for your time and attention here. And as always, please reach out if you have any questions. Have a great rest of your day.